All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement. I know we gotta get it. Excuse me, how much are the Transformers?
Alright guys, we just landed in Chicago!
I'm not happy until I get a cigarette.
Yeah, or we've, let's see, it is 8:29 in the a.m. We woke up at what, 3:30 this morning?
3:30, been going since.
Barely made her flight, no joke. Think Greco and the Sprucher is waiting for us.
What's going on, guys? So as you can see, we got Greco in the house.
Woof.
We got Spruch.
What up?
In the house. So we just got the rental and we looked up a estate sale. And we're here. A little sketch. A little bit. I mean, it's... What do you guys think? What do you think this is okay?
No, this is a good
You don't think we'll like walk in and get murdered?
I mean, they got armored doors and windows.
I've been in worse situations.
Yeah. It said, what did the title say for this?
Religious collectibles.
Okay. So
which is
religious,
what we're looking for.
Right. So we're going to go inside and see what we can find, and maybe some candles, you know, something like that.
Some blow molds.
Peace be with you.
Yeah. And wish us luck.
So what did we find already? Some class sets. Ooh, All for One, Whitney Houston.
All for One.
Leanne Rimes, Kenny G.
I had a big crush on Leanne Rimes.
Oh, me too, I had her poster on my wall when I was a kid.
Dude, ooh. Kenny Rogers.
That's Bing Crosby, you missed the best one there.
Ooh. Well, we got down her.
No, oh, but
Kenny
yes.
Garth, that's a good one.
Craig and I, we do collect VHS.
All right, so nothing really in the house. So we're gonna go in the old garage, see what's in there. Greco doesn't seem too enthused. He needs to wake up. He needs to wake up.
So I don't know if you know
what's in here.
Some Black and Decker. Yeah.
Got some wires down there.
Oh,
some fittings. Well, caught y'all slipping. Look at all that.
Oh,
look at all this.
Well, I think a lot of people did.
Caught y'all slipping.
Adam Costello.
All right, so I did find this sealed copy of Kenny Rogers' Greatest Hits. I think I'm going to pull the trigger.
Sealed,
Unbreakable.
That's a good movie.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Also found a copy of Crocodile Dundee with the inserts. I'm going to grab that. A buck a piece. Thanks to Boston Mike. Look.
We're all doing the Inception.
Yeah, Inception, Unbreakable, Sealed. Yay. These guys.
What do you boys get?
Kindergarten Cop. It's not that tumor.
Wait, who's
your daddy?
Which camera am I talking to?
You, you can talk
going.
To both. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So.
So I got this one right here.
You guys got Seven. You guys got Abbott and Costello, and then now you guys, Seven and Abbott and Costello.
Yeah. Well. Dancing Stars. We got Top Spin. Yeah, let's make some room. Make a pile.
The Infinity Ratatouille.
Ratatouille. How much are the games?
How many you want?
I don't know.
I won't convict this until
Chess Master. Interesting.
Pinball.
Pinball Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That's a nice one.
I think
Greg. Oh, yeah.
Should we get Greg add a watch? The weight has to
be. What's the name?
I haven't heard of that one before.
Mm.
Anybody need Avengers watch?
That's
kind of cool.
Greatest hits. FIFA?
I saw that. Yeah, I saw it. There's a
watch. I don't know. On top.
It's all like peeling.
Yeesh.
Greco, do you know about any of these? Know anything about any Disney stuff?
No, I don't know that.
Not really.
Got the batteries in it. His eyes light up.
That's cool.
But he
That's
doesn't cool. spin around. I don't know what's wrong with him.
What are you asking?
We'll tell mom the babysitter's dead.
That's a good one.
Another kindergarten cop.
Dude, so many kindergarten cops today.
Misery.
Stir crazy.
Sealed.
Backdraft.
Coming to America.
Home Alone.
Ooh, coming to, no, Air America.
Twista.
Ooh, Twista.
Jurassic Park. Hey, look, Ransom again.
Again. What are these? Ooh, Betas?
Oh.
Is that Betas?
Driving Miss Daisy.
What else we got in there? There's a Beverly Hills. Robin Hood. Damn.
Might be a... Oh, I can't see some of these.
Dude, you got the score, though.
Yeah.
You got the score.
Oh, that helps.
Look at that.
What'd you get?
Halloween.
Oh, there you go. Cool.
So this beer sign is pretty rad.
Not that.
That's cool.
Not that.
Not that? Oh, okay.
So we got Billy Williams, Billy Pierce. But
there's one the ball that's right autographed a whole Man. Bunch of stuff.
Yeah, this one down here.
And this one, too.
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know what they
are. Do
I just put your feet up? Is there any COA?
No, you get them all in person, or his uncle did.
How much?
So, $70.
Or best offer. Reasonable offer.
I think you should make an offer, dude.
I have to get it in my luggage.
I know.
I still gotta think of all the other stuff I gotta.
Easy.
That's true. That's true. I was doing like this. Oh,
you, want me to
ooh.
Flip out?
What are you
trying to do?
Trying to catch it.
Oh, scene.
Trying to what?
Can we make it through one meal without you making a scene?
I'm not the one making a scene. I'm just standing up for the little guy.
You're making a scene right now, sir.
You're making a scene.
Okay. Right here in front of this pizza.
Who think they're entitled, thinking they want to dictate who can collect and be passionate.
Damn.
I'm sick of all of you.
Tell him, Greco.
You want a cigarette after that?
He's going to need something.
Ed under a Goodwill sign. Come on, Slowpoke. Let's go. Let it go. Let it go.
That's awesome.
Oh, dude, that's pretty
is that
sick.
Yeah,
that
is vintage. Yeah.
$4.
Is it complete?
I don't know.
Let's open it up.
Dude, who found that?
It was just here.
So you found it?
I
your
it.
First find?
Welcome to America,
Papa. Ooh.
Where are all these micro machines going? Super Auto World! Go for a road test. It's smooth, then bumpy. Take a ride in the elevator.
Going up!
Keep them coming. There's a Super Auto World car display.
I'll take this one.
Raise the lube racks. Move the ramps around.
Red truck coming down.
See what your car will look like in lots of cool colors. Come on, bring your micro machines to Super Auto World. When we close for the day, just carry it away. Think big, play small. Micro machines. New micro machines, Super Auto World playset. Vehicle collection sold separately. You put it together.
I mean, we should take it to the show, right?
Yeah, I know, right? Let's do it. We can always do it as a giveaway.
We could.
Anybody want to buy it?
Like, Ed's first find.
It's micro machines.
How much is it?
It's glue.
$4.
$4? Yeah, we got to get that.
Machines.
Oh, I can't bring it.
Look. Look. $4.
Ed found it.
Ed found it.
Well, there's no way he can bring that back with him.
We're going to bring it to the show.
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 We're going to pick up stuff to bring to the show.
And then we're going
to
just give it away.
We'll do a giveaway. Yeah.
The old lady that's...
Well, we're not giving anything away. We're selling everything.
Hey, look behind you.
You find something else? BB-8.
Oh, Thatcher's shocker. What the hell is that?
Is that where it's
is there anything in that Star Wars box?
It's an RC Target exclusive.
Yeah.
It might be something.
Laser challenge?
Greco always finds those.
Greco, you want laser challenge?
Oh, I do.
Oh. Oh. Oh, it works.
It's all there.
It is all there.
It's only $4.
Pick it up in the room.
Whoopies.
Oh, show. But you pick up isn't the there like a thousand?
There's a lot of stuff over here. There's Operation. What about this classic Operation? The skill game. That's an oldie, but a goodie. Cars.
Battleship.
Oh, Scrabble. That.
Junior.
There's no way that could be caught in this
stuff. The
Royal Game of
it's
India.
It's deluxe.
Deluxe.
Even.
Craig, can you just get a clue, bud?
Here you go, Ed. Find it, USA.
Find it, USA.
Hey, Ed. Ed, are you smarter than a fifth grader?
No.
Probably not.
We got everybody.
What did you put?
Look in the back of Greco's pocket. I put a wooden hammer.
Hey, Greco. Greco.
Yeah, we're grabbing
Greco.
That.
Greco. Samadios. Let me see your butt. Turn around.
I lost
wiggle
a lot of it.
Just a little bit.
What is that?
See what's in your back pocket?
The hammer.
Laying down the hammer. I'm gonna try to catch these fools slipping. Hey, did y'all see these games?
Yeah, I was looking at this.
What is that?
The production value right
now. Oh.
Yo guys, this is the NARC coming to you live from 1997. I'm the first picker of all time doing video. Oh, hey bud.
I hate you, Mass. One more time. So Ed ended up picking up
the micro machine. And
so this is actually 1998.
Yeah,
we found out
95.
24 years old.
Yeah, and for
if I can look as happy bucks. As this kid here, yeah. I mean,
you get paid probably like what $3,000 for that.
I don't.
That kid's name. That's Brett McDaniels.
Brett McDaniels.
He does a lot. He did a lot of toy modeling back in the day.
And if you sign that, you get a little more for it.
Yeah.
I think he's gonna be here this weekend.
He's signing. He's so signing. Maybe we can get it signed.
What? What's happening? What's going on?
Let's get out of here. I remember one of the recent videos.
Oh no!
You had him. Well, you had the gorilla guy. I can't remember his name, but I found these in a recent lot that I picked up, and I was like, you know who would like this?
I would.
Eddie.
I would.
We are going to meet up with my buddy Dan. He knows of a secret garage sale right before King County. So we're going to hit that up and hopefully find some deals and some steals.
Deals and some steals. This guy is selling to buy even more at the Chicago Toy Show.
That's right.
So we're going to give him some money in exchange for some doors.
He's not going to be able to buy much because I am buying nothing.
What you got so far, man? No way. Teen Wolf?
Enoch cookies for
nice. That's a good man. That's a good.
You gotta get pushing, man. It's like a wedding sale dress here.
They're all fighting to get in because they're wearing
it. What else we got over there?
Cable.
Priest.
Pretty dope.
Wolverine.
I actually have that hat. That Master's hat.
Oh, I didn't even see that.
Alright, so.
Oh, babies.
Mighty Ducks.
Won't you come true?
Mighty Ducks? I don't know.
Rush Kids?
Who's this guy? That's kind of neat.
Did you see the little hat?
I did. I actually have that one.
Oh,
okay. The poster is sweet.
Can we bring this to the show and say, hey, can
you want to play some wrestlers?
Those are cool. Those are cool.
30 second table, move along.
How do you wrestle, man?
Eddie.
Oh, Ed.
What am I supposed to do with this?
I don't know if you had that Robin you were talking earlier. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's another turtle figure. It is. Too bad? Or not too bad, but... Oh, here you go, Ed. I have this one.
Ooh, it's another Venus.
Do you have a Venus?
Hey.
I have it. I don't know what that is.
Defenders of the Universe.
Oh yeah.
What else is down there, guys?
Some Polly Pocket house behind.
Oh sweet. Is that Polly Pocket?
Yeah, it might be newer Polly Pocket.
Oh yeah.
My newer Polly Pocket stuff didn't sell, and my son stole it. I'm like, all right, have fun.
Yeah, there you go. You know what
my pants once.
Are you gonna get them?
Oh yeah. I read these. You want the turtles or the rentals?
Teen Wolf.
The one I wanted, right?
Is that the one you wanted?
That's the main reason I grabbed those.
I actually Ewoks. Ewoks.
It'll go in your birthday basket.
What do you think?
What
is it?
Toys R Us? The camp photo is like $10. Robotech, I'm at $15, I would say.
I'll say
it's still missing a gun, but it's still, you don't see the
canopy. Which is nice. Yeah. The guns are probably going to be the easy part to find if you want to try to complete it.
Yeah. Do it.
What is
it? Wait. That's what I said. Hit him at Greco price, $15.
Make it interesting.
All right, let's do it.
I'm at $15 for me. Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Curves on this one. Right?
And then...
Okay.
Okay. What is this?
Huh.
No idea. No idea. That's kind of a weird thing.
Oh, it was an artist card, and like you flip it over, and it's got like...
It's got both sides, yeah.
How about that?
Huh?
Yeah.
I just picked it up, a promo thing back. I used to do conventions.
That's cool, though. Yeah, I mean,
it's definitely different.
Interesting.
He kind of reminds me of... Do you remember when they had like the costumes from back in the
day?
Yeah, where it was like really kind of bloated looking.
All right, man. What'd you get?
I got a sheet for my bed.
For your bed? Nice.
I think the hotel has sheets, though. Or where are we staying? For your own sheets?
Yeah, man. You can.
What kind of deal did you get on that?
I got it for $5. It's what I wanted, but he gave me a great deal on everything else.
Oh yeah.
Totally fine with that.
100%, man.
Is it Ruxpin?
Yeah, Teddy Ruxpin.
Yeah.
Oh, and it's got
and his pal Grubby.
Grubby too.
All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement.
Are you
basement
invading?
Invaders today.
It is an attic.
Can we go through this every time you visit? I think it's about time you ship something back.
I just paid what he asked for it.
Nice.
Yeah.
Which was? People want to know.
Is it over?
That was great. It just looked like he was like, I don't want to be here.
So what do you think? Another town?
Another basement. I know we gotta get it. I know we gotta get it. Know we gotta get it somehow. I know we gotta get it. I know we gotta get it. Know nowhere is safe. Attics, basements, in between, common areas. We're the common area invaders.
So my buddy Dan reaches out to me and he's like, hey, I live in the area. You guys should totally come to the house and check out my collection. And also, I have a basement full of vintage toys and video games.
So yeah, we got a direct invitation to Dan's basement, which we're always super appreciative of, these, you know, these open doors that people are opening for us. First they're closed and then they're open.
This was a big basement with lots of toys, and I like it. I like basements with toys in them.
Well, when you first walk in, there's just toys and collectibles everywhere, like organized. It was really nice and organized. And then he brought us down the basement to his inventory, and I was like, bam, this is awesome.
See anything down there, Dan?
So far, I'm going too slowly.
Yeah. There's some trolls.
Trying to keep all in one bin. He has
some trolls down here. You know, got some hook action right here. What else do we got?
21 gigawatts!
Gigawatts? Gigawatts!
Oh, dude! Yeah. Where's the rock? Did anybody pick up the rock from the other
one? Oh, that would have been perfect.
Oh. But no, don't take any of the stuff.
Got some GoBot cards in here. Oh, there's your Chuck Norris.
Yeah.
Karate Commandos.
Chuck Norris, Karate Commandos.
Bring it up, hang it down, find quarts of evil forever.
Figures sold separately.
Location, Tibet. Assignment, recover stolen microchip. Protecting it was Super Ninja.
Hi-ya!
First, Timo stood up to him.
Hi-ya!
And was down. Then, Reed Smith flew in.
Hi-ya!
And was grounded. But now it's his karate against mine.
Hi-ya!
Chuck Norris, Karate Commandos. Chuck Norris, Super Ninja, Reed Smith, Kimo, and other figures sold separately. New from Kenner.
Who are you looking at? You got Chuck Norris?
Well, no, one of the ninjas.
There's some Motu in here.
Oh, you don't need Chuck Norris?
I do.
There we go. Look at that. Look at that. All right, we got some parts over here. I already see, like, Muckman's can. What is that? Toy Biz. Whiplash. We got Casey Jones back. Yeah, that's pretty rad. Poster book. I never seen that.
That's pretty neat. And
that crane.
I saw this here.
I saw that.
Thick crane. What is that, like a wrestling buddy?
Looks like a wrestling buddy. I would guess.
Would you wrestle with this buddy?
I would totally wrestle with this buddy. 100%.
What is that? Does it have like a thingy on it?
Dan, do you know what this is?
I don't.
It was a new, I want to say it was in a print of either 40 or 50. I don't know the artist that did them.
Okay.
That's crazy. That's
pretty cool, though. Pretty cool.
Yeah. Okay. I'd never seen it before, and honestly, I got this from Hatchtar, the guy that we just came to.
Oh, okay.
What's this stuff?
So Dan's basement was freaking amazing. I loved it there. We were there just at the right time because he got in a huge lot, I think, a couple days before. He hadn't really gone through all of it, but, I mean, there's five of us, we can pretty much dig out all the good stuff for him. So we're actually providing him with a service here, and I think we did good. But damn, there's some treasures hidden down there.
Got in here, guys. It's not 5 bucks. Got some turds. Leo. Weenuts. What else we got in here, guys? We got a Splinter. Donnie.
Thank you.
I will take your word for it.
All right. We got some loose figgies.
Drag all this.
Yes, please. There we go. Do you have a complete pizza thrower? Because here's.
I do.
Okay.
Oh.
I could be wrong, but I think.
That's a good one.
I have them.
Got some vintage Star Wars. In this bucket. Look at all that. There's a Jabber. We got two play sets. We got a Yoda. Got a Salacious Crumb right there. And some marbles. Some marbles! Dan was like, hey, get some VHS. He's like, I got a few. And then look what's in this stack. That is just too cool. Reform gym. Let's check it out. Look at that. I'm definitely going to pick that out. Got some Ranger stuff. ET. Very cool.
With the glowing, or is that a replica? It's a replica because it looks kind of over here. You can see.
1981. What? That's a 1981 Italian scarecrow. Shit me. Dips.
Yeah.
You got
a lot of parts.
Yeah.
That
Halberd.
Yeah.
So, that's pretty cool. You got the Horde Trooper too. Randor. That's crazy. That's a clean Randor. Alright, and this tote. Found a Darkwing Duck. Launchpad and a Quack. This is like the dollar bin right here. So all of these figures are a dollar a piece. So I want to dig a little bit and update you guys as we get through this. Shalom.
I need this.
Yeah, that's a good piece. Those two pieces right here, guys.
Lighting.
Yeah. Have you been picking up much smoke too, or not really?
I have a lot. I'm just actually like missing accessories. So
this is perfect.
Yeah. There's also like a golden sword in there, but I don't think it's like real.
Right.
That one goes to a little bit flying fist.
Yeah. Cracky, what you finding?
There's a bunch of games. I want to see what's going on in here.
The whole bit. DC Universe.
People like that. I wonder if somebody would want that. Saw.
I would think so. Yeah.
PSP.
I mean, horror, man. Can't go wrong, really.
Is that just the outside or is it the disc?
Might just be the casing. All of these. I think Ed was looking for superpowers.
Superpowers.
I said that another box, sweetie pie.
That's all the sections in the bottom.
Oh yeah, I'm hungry.
What's in the samurai?
There you go. Another one. Another one.
Another one.
Another one.
Don't cash out yet, Ed. Oh, wait, wait.
Another one. Another one.
Alright, so we finally get into the Kane County Toy Show, and we're trying to find our footing. I mean, there's so many huge barns and things to chase, and we don't really have a plan of action.
Alright guys, so we are here,
man.
Kane County, at the parking lot cell.
Look at that!
Look at this. Look at that, look at this, look at that.
It's gonna draw.
What do you think, dude?
We got some... I have everything already.
It's a good deal, though.
I was like, yeah. Yeah, I mean, if you're looking...
If you're looking for that,
yeah.
Three figures for 50 bucks.
Three figures for 50 bucks?
That's 50, 50 alone, probably 35.
Yeah. So, you happy?
Yeah, so far, yeah.
First, only the first car, and then look at all this. Major disaster. How much? 50?
50. He's missing like that belief.
250 is just missing that chest piece that plugged in. That's it. That's
tech, tech. I got this last time when we were together. Remember that? Comic Con? I did.
See, here's his hands.
Did you know? I did.
One of our guys is with us.
I did. Yeah,
did.
I got that
score. Did you know?
But did you?
Did you read that?
There's some ghost asbestos.
Ghost asbestos.
Some traps.
Some Centurions. I love that.
Oh,
there's more. There's another Centurion.
What's his name? Ace?
Ace McCloud?
Yep.
He had like a glowing dark one planned. They did some games. Speaks of Rage. Speaks of Ragers.
Right in the rails.
You know, a little bit of everything.
Hey, Joe's?
So, Greco, we go through this every time you visit.
Thank you.
I think it's about time you ship something back.
Why don't you hold on to that?
I'll hold it like this for you.
Was that the loose one?
Are you in love?
That's very cool. I'm always a fan of like the role playing kind of.
I know.
Yeah.
You got the turtle dress up stuff, you got the RoboCop.
I like it.
That's cool with that box. And boxes.
That's a very nice box.
I was actually kind of surprised that Greco would actually ask the guy to pull out the RoboCop role-playing thing. It looked great. It was still in the box. You had the arm module.
We stumble upon this van at the parking lot sale, and we see that there's a box RoboCop playset that Greco has been after for a long time.
I've been eyeing this thing for a while now. I've never really had a super opportunity to grab it complete in the box and in person. I'm there and this happens every time. I'm just hemming and hawing about like do I really want to pay this much? I got to ship it back. You know, it's going to add to the total cost. And it's literally within my grasp. And I'm like, what am I going to do here? And
he's been talking about it. Doesn't shut up about it. I don't need the RoboCop playset. I really need it. Ah!
1,500.
Yeah, I'm
they have like I'm this for
the Master of the Universe.
Oh, yeah.
Is that the merch?
The caps.
Caps.
Oh, for the figures and stuff.
No, that's definitely awesome. Not. These also work on that thing? Or these are just for the figures? Or,
I think those are for the figures, yeah.
That 209 will. Or
yeah, he does it too. And like one of the cars as well, I think.
What do you think?
Maybe.
No, I think you're right.
Maybe. I think I didn't sleep enough.
Thinking, dude. I think you should just pull the trigger.
You'll make me sad. This is my showpiece. This is my eye-catching showpiece.
Well,
I mean, how attached are you to the showpiece?
No, you can
ask.
I mean, but I think with the caps, it's going to make it worth one thing.
Yeah.
But the caps, did it go with that?
No.
No, it's just extra. Thing, yeah. Dun, 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 dun.
The pressure. Dun, dun, dun,
dun. You know how I am.
I know, but we have different philosophies. I'm like, would you take a dollar? And you're like, just buy it.
Just buy it.
I'll do 140 without the caps.
You gotta have the caps, man. You gotta have the caps.
The caps are pretty cool, but I mean, they don't work with this.
No, no.
It's not like they're... Or is it?
Why didn't I just get it? It would have made an awesome story.
You should have bought that box, man. Like, what were you thinking?
Caps on a blister. So, I think that's some holy grail stuff there. And 150 didn't seem too high, at least to me. But then again, I'm not that big of a RoboCop guy. But he is, so I honestly don't know why he didn't just jump on that. That is a cool and awesome piece of toy. That's a cool toy, man.
It would have made a great Attic Invaders episode, but instead I'm an attic hesitator. Don't be an attic hesitator, be an attic invader.
Hey guys, Justice Curry.
About now when the August blurry, like whip.
So we're at Kane County Toy Show. This is amazing. I'm with all my heroes. Look at hero one, hero two, and hero three. But as you guys know with the toy journey, you get everything that you kind of want the production wise. So the white unicorn, the hunt that a lot of us go down is pre-production. And the, you know, one of a kind figures.
Oh yeah.
So some pre-pro figures, they're always in wacky different colors, but I don't know if you can see with the glare. I'll take them out. Yes, test shots. So you got a really neat Batman. Love the cape on that. And then what really is awesome is that Hawkman and the different colors that they used in there.
Is that Justice League?
What's that? Yeah, the Justice League Hawkman. And I don't know which Batman specifically this is, but I'll do some research later and find it. But the parts and pieces, I've been digging through bins, finding all sorts of He-Man, Ninja Turtles, little rare weapons here and there, G.I. Joe. So yeah, it's a fun
Heck
time.
Yeah.
You guys find some stuff too.
Thank you, Justice Curry.
Yeah, Justice Curry.
Got this for $40.
$40.
For the bag.
For the bag.
The bag.
What
the bag's got Thundercats. It's got Motu KO. It's got Ghostbusters. You got something. You got He-Man's.
Yes, some He-Man's.
Figure.
And a figure.
Oh, and a Cosmic Rugs.
$40.
What?
All right, guys. We are officially at King County. There's the guys back there. Everybody?
Everybody!
Spreacher, whoop, whoop. Gricky, Bolston, and we are going to go find our table and get some deals. We already got a ton of great deals, so you're going to see that right now. So Greco found this Pee-wee stuff, but I think... So I was about to say, like, maybe that represents, like, what's her face? The
Miss Yvonne?
Miss Yvonne and the soccer guy,
oh, yeah.
Ricardo.
Oh, is this? Do you think this is, like, a custom?
Maybe. I could be totally wrong, but that's where my mind went. I don't know. It's kind of cool, though. Oh, that is sweet. Check that out. Look at that. That is pretty cool. Very cool. Got some shirts down here. What is this? Batman Returns? Pretty dope.
Is this like paint coming off? Or is it like dirty?
No, man. Maybe it's the blue chipping away? No. Alright guys, first official pickup. Well no, probably second. I got this dino for $10.
You think that was a good deal?
$10? Yeah, absolutely.
I think so. Because these can easily go for like, I don't know, 20 to 30. Depending, but not bad.
Batman, Xenophobe, Mario, Tetris. Tell us, sorry, Marksman. All right, Cracky, what'd you just pick up?
Hey, just kind of random stuff. Like, I got this cool little
Pokemon
Game Boy holder.
That's cool.
Right there.
And you got?
And I got a loose copy of Mario Superstar Baseball.
And how much did you get both of them for?
$10 total.
Deal!
Deal!
A second. That's not my deal.
Some are on card, some are like loosey goosey.
Check these out. Ooh! Did I have that dartboard?
No, that's
no, maybe not. Maybe it was another one. Skeleton Warriors. That's crazy looking. And got all these guys. Very cool. We got some great comics. Okay, Chance got this awesome banner for us. Make sure you check out the Toy Stash on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all the above, right?
Yeah, all the
yeah. Whatnot? Whatnot as well?
I think they're on social.
Where's Mike at? Where's Mike and Sprooch?
Where's Boston Mike and Sprooch?
Where are Boston Mike and Sprooch? And those two, like, this was just the beginning of what would blossom into. I'm a little envious. I mean, I want somebody to look at me the way Boston Mike looks at Sprooch.
I mean, I don't know what to explain. I mean, we just met, things, sparks were flying, you know, and we had a great bond. We both loved Joe's, and once we locked eyes at one moment, it was like just music, and I felt Cupid coming above me and shoot me with little arrows. And it was a great time with Mr. Sprooch.
I'm pretty sure I just lost my best friend. Yep, definitely lost my best friend.
So when we were at the Kane County Toy Show, we all tried to stay together and hunt, but it was just so hard because one person would stop and look at stuff, and then the rest of the group would go on, or we'd get separated for some reason or another. But me and Boston Mike hung out pretty much the entire weekend. Just happened to work out that way. Got to know each other pretty well. We've become best friends.
Some Karate Kid.
What?
Figures on card.
What is that? Thing.
What?
That is rare.
Yeah, I was going to say.
That's
I was,
cool.
That's a hard one.
Why did they make a game out of it? Yeah.
All right, finally teamed up with Boston Mike. Old school.
Oh. Of course he's eating the fat.
But look what I picked up.
Wait. You yep. picked up that?
I mean, I just bought it.
Oh, wait, what's in my bag?
One of these.
Oh, we're going to have walkie-talkies down the way.
Yeah. Ewok. Toms. The TMNT Super Mutants. Cyclone Cycle. $90. Do you not have that back there? Pretty sweet piece. What'd you get, man?
Unbreakable.
Yeah, you know what?
Satin ornament? That's pretty cool. Merry Christmas, dudes. What kind of deal did you get?
I just paid what he asked for it.
Nice.
Yeah.
Which was? People want to know.
15.
Bam. Yeah. That's a great deal.
I don't know.
He's not even recording this.
This is nothing. Nothing at all.
Chris.
Yeah, that is pretty sweet. I like this. I'm sure. I'm surprised, like, Greco's not all over that.
It's cheap.
See the owl duffel bag?
That's cool. I did not see that at all.
Did you see the Pee Wee playset?
I don't know if he saw it. Mr. T's Water War. I pity the water. They got this Knight Rider car with the monster. Look at that box right here. Dang. Deluxe figure set. There's Miyagi. Look at all these Street Fighter 2 Joes. 4 days and days. Mortal Kombat, Ninja Force.
Look how cute this guy is.
Look at that little cuter Magoo.
Crocodile.
Crocodile. You're the crocodile hunter. I found something that I need.
Ecto.
Sumo. I don't know. I don't have one, but I see no sandals, no accessories, and they got that ectoplasm. I'm gonna ask about that sumo.
The case that he's not supposed to open.
I can't open it.
Pretty good prices on these Food Fighters. These Mighty Max.
Isn't that a...
What is that?
It's got this silver chest.
Yeah.
It's a Viper Pilot. I'm pretty sure.
I had some chicken right there. Speaking of chicken, I'm starving, guys.
Yeah, dude, I feel you.
Check out these sectars. Oh, look at this. Silverhawks. Just crazy amounts of stuff, guys. Crazy amounts of stuff. Thundercats. Just chilling down there, you know, no big deal. No biggie. Look at that. Look at this. Look at that. Look at that Eternia. Another Mummers 2.
I already got to get another bag for something.
Crazy. Luna Lasher.
Dos al Estrella. Das ist Estrella 2. Oh,
is that the Shrine Door?
Bengali? That's for Argentina, Bengali.
Yeah,
look at his hair. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, the smaller head, yeah. That's his Brazil. Those are Brazil. And that's his Leo.
Woo!
That's a Leo toy.
Leo. Check that out.
Good day, guys.
Leo toys.
That's Argentina, so you can see the color.
Yeah.
Even his face looks different.
Mm-hmm.
The top for the scooter. Inside.
Okay.
But yeah. This is like 90, 95. You can open it.
Okay. Let's check it out.
Mouser?
Oh, okay. Dino? Yeah.
I'll just open it up for you. Tell me if you want anything.
Oh. Nice. I got that. I got that. Okay, buddy. Thank you. Leo.
Another one of the orbs.
Oh,
it picked up a bunch of these yesterday.
He's
got 50 on it.
Man, Craig, Narc, thank you so much for setting up this whole thing. This was insane. You had the hookups. You got us to go to Dan's basement. You got us to go to Hatch. This thing was amazing. This was only day one. I'm already baffled. I don't know how we're gonna top this on day two, but I'm ready for it.
Ed, are you pumped? Are you gonna do this? Are you mad?
So, is this a one or a seven?
Dancy?
Oh, get the move.
I'm down for one.
What do you think? So how much is it? What's the deal?
160 a person.
So 800 for everything.
Yep.
Saw that thing, my little tick. Great. Edit that out.
1, 2, 3, go. He's pulling it. Come on, Ed. Let's go.
I don't know, this is a weird.
Greco and
Greco!
Son.
Greco!
It's me!
It's
crazy damn cops here. Seriously. Should call it RoboCop. Freaking Belgium.
Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement. What's going on, guys, and welcome to today's video. And this video is not an actual Attic Invaders episode. I'm just calling this Attic Invaders 2.5 because we visit Quake Collectibles. It is a toy shop outside of the Chicago area. And also, we take Ed to Walmart for his very first time. We got some good moments in there, so I wanted to share with you guys. Unfortunately, the footage from Quake Collectibles, the music in there was so loud that I had to put some other music over it so I wouldn't get a copyright strike. So sorry about that. I know people like to hear commentary during these hunts, but unfortunately was not able to do that. So guys, make sure you are subscribed to the channel and like the video. And here is Quake Collectibles.
dad goes to Walmart, take one. How are you feeling about this, dude? Like, this is perfect thumbnail for this short video.
Yeah, I mean, like, Ed goes to Walmart.
That's right.
It had to happen.
What are your expectations? What are you feeling right now?
Just a big store?
It's pretty big.
Yeah, I'm hoping we can find some toys.
Well, let's go see. Let's go shake a leg.
Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Peppers?
Toothpaste.
Deodorant. Toothpaste.
Toiletries.
Toiletries.
We didn't get to do it last time due to thunderstorms. And,
that's right.
This time.
And flooding.
He said thunder.
He said he's been working on it. He's been working on it, man.
Been awake for 24 hours.
Don't give him a complex. All right, this is going to be a slow-mo. Whoa, wow. Were you looking for baby food? Do you need a barbecue pit?
Because I got them.
They have a barbecue pit?
Yeah, man. Different models. They got vitamin D right
there. How do you ever find anything over here?
Well, once you know the lay of the land, you can kind of get in and out pretty quick. How you feeling, dude? Are you liking it? Feeling okay? So the clearance aisles over here, they usually have like some pretty decent
toys.
Like a Motu Origins maybe, or some of the reissue turtles are on clearance for like
clearance section
super
is
cheap.
Big as like a regular store.
Oh.
Turbo Man
25.
Turbo Man.
John Cena with a t-shirt 15.
Why did they put him out when it's like exactly the same freaking thing as before? That's insane. I had all of these. I had this one, I had that one.
Yeah, that one too.
Which
one?
Is
that the Megatron?
This is not clearance, right?
Yeah.
Well, it used to be 56.
It's not super clearance.
No.
I still have them.
They still get Ghostbuster ones? Huh. We found the toy section. Okay, so this way, yeah. This way is all the cool, the better toys. So this is all like the bikes and stuff. There we go. Here we go. Look at this wondrous world.
I don't have straight ups.
That's a comic version too, I think.
Yeah. I don't have that one, but
you just got her. You just got the one.
Yeah, but
get some Pokemon cards and have a battle.
Spoiler alert.
I got most of them.
What about spoiler alert? Oh wow, she's not one that you see very often.
She's not, actually.
People are gonna be like, like, how much for that Transformers?
You know what, buddy? It's free.
Excuse me, how much are the Transformers?
All right, so we are back. I hope you guys enjoyed that footage. So the only pickup I got from Toy Collectibles is this freaking action figure. Boss and Mike said, you gotta get it. It looks just like you. And I think Mike got the Greco Fabulous action figure. And that was about it. We just had a lot of fun. So guys, make sure you're subscribed to the channel and stay tuned for next Monday for Attic Invaders Part 3. You don't wanna miss it. Ed, are you pumped? Are you gonna do this? Are you mad?
No. Is this a 1 or a 7?
Dancy?
Oh,
get the move. I'm down for one.
What do you think? So how much is it? What's the deal?
160 and part of it.
So 800 for everything.
Yep. Hey guys, Greco interview with me in an arc. Hey Greco, how you been? I hate you YouTubers! Why do you always hate me?
Did you have fun on that trip?
Oh yeah, sure.
Oh my god, why do you sound like Bailey?
guess it's Porch Invaders.
Porch Invaders.
No,
Sidewalk
Invaders. How about
Sidewalk?
All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement.
What's going on, guys?
What up?
Day two, Kane County Toy Fair. Is it Toy Fair? Toy Show.
Toy show.
The Chicago Toy Show, actually.
Greg just woke up. Guys.
I just woke up, and there's mess.
Wow! What was that?
So let's get these toys. All right, guys. Day two.
What's the game plan?
What? I don't know. I was just going to ask you guys that. What's the deal today? What are we doing? What are you looking for?
B-roll.
B-roll?
B-roll? For B-roll, and okay. Maybe some deals.
Maybe some deals? Look at this. That, guys. Look back there. It's crazy. Just one building. We got a Hall of Justice.
You could probably spend the whole day here in this one.
I think so. You're right.
It's fine.
It's fine. What are you looking at over there, Eddie?
Doesn't this look like something Mike would be into?
Yeah.
Butthole.
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 Yeah.
Definitely.
I think you're right.
Okay.
Butthole with teeth. So, Grecky, I found...
Good. Take care of your duffel bags,
yeah,
please.
Yeah.
Please.
But still has its taggy.
Yeah, come with that.
You looking for a carry-on, sir?
And I'm not getting yelled at for touching this one.
Oh, that's true. Ooh, fancy. Comes with some paper.
Vintage.
That's good. Paper is even yellowed. Good. Good.
Seven.
So, guys...
75.
Is it seven?
I need your opinion.
I might make my first big boy purchase... I want that.
Talking out. With tape.
And it works.
Working with tape.
What do you think?
Can you trust the post-it note?
I mean, no.
I think we're going to need some more...
We need a van layers. To put it in, though.
We have a van, right? Unless,
yeah, but...
Unless Light Spreaks and...
But they left.
Mike took off, yeah.
They left and they're like laughing all the way to the van.
If we have a van,
yeah.
It's a deal for 20 and...
20? Okay. But that's probably going to be a thing.
Yeah.
It has the instructions, too.
So, is this a 1 or a 7?
This looks like a 1.
I'm taking it
home. I think that's a 1.
Seven. Is it a 1? Then I'll take it
Get
home.
Your finger over it when you pull it. Yeah. I'll take this.
For 5. It's a nice box.
How are you going to take that home?
Fold it out? Or,
yeah.
I'll have to open it up, but I mean, I would do that, actually.
Yeah.
I haven't with the size, so.
I would just be worried about that.
Oh, yeah, because it's, like...
Yeah.
I could make it work. I could, like, fill it up with toys, actually.
You could.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't, like, I'll lose a little bit over there.
Are you going to buy another bag while you're here?
A bag?
Another, like, chicken?
What's a bag?
Like a...
Okay.
Suitcase.
It's not going to be a one, right?
Yeah, you got to be careful with them because break.
What?
They break easy.
They break, yeah.
Why does it open up?
It's supposed to... I think there's something inside. It's supposed to pop out.
How much is he?
50. How much? 50 bucks.
50.
How much is the Baloo?
20.
20?
Yeah. How much would it be if you broke it? My wife actually wants a carded one. You better ooze it before you lose it.
One more time.
You better ooze it before you lose it.
25
a price tag. So we got the Mario for 25 with a price tag.
25 a price tag.
But I found this definite tag customer.
$20.
What's the
I kind of like
menu?
It. I'll probably get it. It's a me, Eddie. Hello.
What's the matter with you?
What's the matter, yo?
I'm down for one.
What do you think? So how much is it? What's the deal?
160 a person.
So 800 for everything.
Yep. Yeah. You just put it on the van and we'll go somewhere where it's dry and do this.
Yeah. We could actually take it there.
We could.
Drop it in one of the big
garage just starts up.
Not these, but use some of the covered bins, like two or three covered bins, I'd be happy.
Yeah. Let's try. All of this. Alright, so we bought all this stuff. We gotta get it all in the van. All of this. And we are late to our meet and greet.
So unprofessional.
So unprofessional.
Next black.
Grecky, can you get that one? I'm holding the door. I'm the door holder.
Figure out who. All right. First.
So poor Greco.
Help me.
We bought everything you saw for $700.
It went 60. Well, Greco get the.
Oh yeah, Greco got all this Pokemon.
Pokemon.
Stuff.
Yeah.
You think
he deals with us, but he wants to deal with him?
I guess it's Porch Invaders.
Porch Invaders. No, Sidewalk
how about
Invaders.
Storm Invaders. Storm Invaders.
Storm Invaders. Storm Chasers.
Storm Raiders.
Storm Raiders.
Storm Raiders. Chasers. Is that a real thing?
To give you guys a little context on what is going on with this huge pickup that we just got the day before, we went to this, it was like a Pokemon, it was a card shop, mostly cards, they had some action figures, and they were having a sidewalk sale. So the person that was running the sale said, hey guys, if you come tomorrow morning, I'm bringing all of this 80s vintage toy goodness here. And you guys can totally have first dibs. Of course, we leave the toy show a little early to go see what this sidewalk sale has. And it is tons of vintage Star Wars action figures, Toy Biz. What else was there? Some Transformers, some Gundam, all kinds of stuff. The footage from the draft that we did, because we all split the entire lot. Ed will have it on his channel, so check out Ed's Retro Geek Out. Make sure you're subscribed because he will have all the draft footage of all of that. While we were at the toy show, we ran into our buddy Justice Curry, and he was like, hey guys, you should totally drive up to my place in Michigan, check out the collection, and also I have a basement, a full basement full of toys for sale. So why not? Let's head to Michigan. So Justice Curry invited us over to check out his man cave, or his toy lair, or the Justice lair, and also pick through some of these toys that he's been picking up. So we are next door, and I don't know, I guess this is his basement. We're hunting through, seeing what we can find, trying to get some good deals and additions to our collections. So let's go check it out.
Or the Camel Cobra Khan. Or the very desirable, this is one of the top, the Leo Faker, the Bandito, because he has the dark eyes. So I just love going down these rabbit holes and finding things. And
whoa, is that real Sun?
Yeah, that's a Pigman Sun from the Sunman line, which luckily I got a few years ago before they skyrocketed.
This is also a variant of the Modulok, right?
Yep, from Topps Toys, and it has the green arms. And then you get into, you know, customs. So I find very talented people that can make a battle cat. That looks great. Yeah.
Metlar chilling on the flag.
Tendril Metlar. That's right.
These are cool, actually.
Yep, I got a buddy that that has this his own toy line, and I purchased one not too long ago, and he's real talented.
You got the Oculus in that thing. I was like, that's a toy. No, that's actually just an Oculus in there.
Yes.
Whoa.
And the Venus Flytrap was from a G.I. Joe convention set years ago. And then I put, Madball Oculus in there.
A little custom work on the slime pit here.
Yep. That's Joe Amato did that. All sorts of things hidden here, there, and He-Man lovers, the variants of the Blue Road Ripper.
Okay.
And nobody, I mean, it's It's a white unicorn. You can't find that any place. Death floor with the sprinkles inside. Yeah. So you're supposed to squeeze his. Yeah, you squeeze that, and I don't know if you can see all
it's
the
not
little.
Yellowed or anything.
No, wow. I got crazy lucky on that. And it's the original weapons. This came from a friend. This was his. But most of the time, the water evaporates. So there's some YouTube videos out there on how to repurpose them and get in there and get the water back in. So I had to do that. So yeah.
Wow. So do you have all the original Motu on card?
I did.
You did?
And it's just the collecting cycle. What ends up happening? Yep. I have them for many years. And then I want to put new things up there, but I don't have space. So I thinned it down just about a year ago to just the ones that were sentimental to me. And I let go of the other ones so I could, you know, pack it with some other spots.
Beautiful.
That out in the family room. This came from Kane County. Uncut. These are actually the Wonder Bread. So everyone calls Wonder Bread He-Man. But when you sent in the flyer, you got these trading cards.
Okay.
And this was the uncut sheets.
Wow.
There was this old man at Kane County that had like a stack of 10 of them. And I'm like, I'll buy them all.
Holy moly.
Jeez. And it's my collecting. I have to constantly hustle and buy and sell toys. Because I didn't use a dime of my family money for this collection. So yeah, I'm going to take you guys into a room filled with my inventory.
Mwah.
Is that a real eco castle?
Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
No, that's the best thing on the shelf right now.
come no, look at this before we get it.
I'm like, well, we got the My Pet Monster.
Whoa.
Victor Skursen's letter from Iceland made that with the Beast Man, My Pet Monster. I just love the customs.
Cool.
That's sweet. And then the what you just alluded to a second ago, the Monster Castle.
Dang.
Yeah. With filled up with these figures. They're called Fantastic Stars. Spain and South America.
Is that like a knockoff thing or is it kind of branded?
They kind of made one-offs of Master Universe, because they didn't want to get sued, so they made them very similar, where fans would recognize kind of the color schemes and whatnot, but they added, like, Judge Dredd, which I have coming in the mail, and they added, I think there's, Mr. T up there.
Oh, that's so cool.
So this is basically just like a knockoff or like a KO replacement for like kids that can get a gray skull. Came out of Germany, I think.
Yep.
Yeah, you got the hand. That thing lights up over there. Or is supposed to light up.
Yep. And a unique hand right here.
It has the aesthetic of Castle Grayskull, but less features, less playability, but honestly, like a really cool display piece to pop some figures in front of. And over here, you got one of the guys. Actually, he looks like Castle Eco.
Yep, that's Castle, a custom.
It's a custom?
Yep, okay. Yep, a custom that looks just like the castle. But the major difference with this versus Castle Grayskull is this thing's fragile. You look at it wrong and it just shatters into 1,000 pieces. Super thin plastic. So that's why they're quite rare, because many of them didn't survive. A lot of G.I. Joe vintage boxed figures. These bins have Godzilla and Beast Wars and knickknacks and Transformers, and you guys can help yourself just start pulling stuff away. And
where's the turtle stuff?
Not a lot of turtle stuff. Mm-hmm. I had a guy clean me out recently.
Okay.
So
okay.
Turtles. I got modern turtles.
Oh, the Super Sevens?
Yeah, the Super Seven stuff. But as far as vintage, only a handful.
Gotcha.
They're not complete yet.
What'd you find, buddy?
G.I. Joe's. Get away, Justin. Spooch, go away. Oh, should we send?
Yeah, Justin sent me his list of what he needs.
Should we send like a picture to Justin?
Message him, see if he's landed.
He already sent me his want list. I'm going to take care of him later.
What a nice guy.
You know.
It fits me.
I'm hungry. I don't know. I'm stupid.
Poland,
yeah.
Denmark,
Netherlands, Spain. Iceland.
It's all the same, you know.
Well, yeah. I haven't used Iceland yet. Thank
oh,
you.
Oh yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah.
Not much.
Really?
Nah. Because it's not complete.
A Jabba isn't much.
Demi Jedi.
Parts that I haven't matched up yet. Again, it came from my buddy, so I just didn't know which parts to go to yet.
Stuff, so.
Yeah.
Do you want any of black?
Yeah, I was going to take a
pretty cool one.
Take a look.
Certainly, sir.
Certainly.
Oh, what's this dude?
I don't know.
I'm going to
get 15 Vipers. There's enough for an army build. Like,
in there?
Yeah, all three bins. I mean, all three bins. A bunch of bins.
Yeah, thank you.
I found a storage unit filled with thousands and thousands of Salacious Crumb and that little hookah thing that he had.
Okay.
So they made custom little boxes and put original factory sealed Salacious Crumbs in there. And I picked up this whole little display thing with vintage.
That's awesome.
Isn't that crazy?
That's cool.
But he had so many of them, he was just flooding eBay with them. And, you know, they were originally $20 a piece mm-hmm. before that unit was found.
Sure.
And then they went down to, you know, $8
a piece. I don't know. Where did it come from?
And, again, it's horrible in here with the lighting.
Yeah.
But Batman Gladiator, like a Spartan. Let's see if we can see it better. I've seen pictures of it loose. This mm-hmm. does not do it justice. It is freaking awesome.
That's a really Play really Arts, cool. right?
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, Play Arts.
Hey.
The issue with these, there's for sale, but the problem is some are worth $10 and some are worth $100.
Yeah,
so I have
yeah.
to look them up because I don't know the values on these.
I know.
Probably the ones that won are worth.
Right.
That's the problem. This guy, yeah.
I posted a picture on social media not too long ago.
Here we go.
Thinking of selling these, and I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah, everybody's probably messaging
me. I got so many messages, crazy. And I wasn't prepared with prices. That's not my usual style.
What?
Look at this. That's a good one.
Look at this pretty face.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, that's a good one. Just look at the back.
This dude,
look
he's got... Like,
the Two-Face. You got the
back.
Oh. Yeah.
Greggy, you see that?
Yeah, don't.
Is that the one that you saw at King County?
No, this is like a custom or something.
Oh, it's a custom. Yeah. That is sweet.
Yeah.
Like it.
Welcome to the Force, kid. Nice shoes.
We're in Justin's basement. We got a gray skull just hanging.
Chilling. Hanging, chilling.
And then above Ed, we got a Snake Mountain. And then, what's that? Silver Hawks? Just,
yeah. That's silver
yeah. Just resting, you know, waiting for nighttime. Craziness.
What do you think of my maybe pile?
I like your maybe pile.
I gotta get the Jabba thing away. It's too big for me.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you got a solid set, man.
We see it over at ours.
Yeah.
So. I like the Silverhawks because that's it. Like,
yeah. That's a great piece.
That's not too expensive. I'm taking it home.
I don't think he is, actually.
I don't think he's that bad. It doesn't matter to me mm-hmm. that it's valuable. I just like that you know, yeah. attracts me. And it looks cool. It looks great next to some turtles, even.
I like that. Good pick on that.
Yeah, I mean, I picked out a few. Mm-hmm. I recognize these. Like this one and this one. I like the color.
I like the color this one a lot.
They're definitely something I never see.
It looks like a Contra right there. Roadhouse.
Actually,
what is this?
The gnarly. It's the Rock Lords.
Rock Lords, and I got a Salacious Rum. I got Crumb, and I got one.
Everybody got things.
Everybody's kung fu fighting.
Tired.
Yeah.
Dying.
Yes.
Hey, kitty cat.
Hey guys, so we just came, saw, and conquered. What did you guys think of? Let's start with his collection. What did you guys think?
Wow.
Love it.
It's impressive. Like, even someone who pretends to like toys like me really appreciates this.
Yeah. Like, if you could pick one thing from this room to take home, what would it be?
Oh my gosh. I don't... That's probably going to be one of the hardest choices
right.
to make.
Eddie?
I want the Eco Castle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that thing Ford is freaking sick. Freaking sick. This was overwhelming. Justice, thank you so much for having us over and your time, man. And great meeting you at Kane County. And I'm glad we're all best friends now. Yeah! Do it for this episode. I believe we are, what is this, day four going into day five, and the next episode you will see is our drive back all the way from Michigan to Texas. So guys, let's see what happens.
Mess. We are stuck on the highway. Some guy stole an ambulance in Chicago.
Lost the mic live on the scene.
I can't find the cheese that came with my White Castle fries.
What'd you find there?
Transformer?
Transformer?
I grabbed some vintage My Little Ponies, guys.
Yeah.
Nothing to see here. Moving along.
You guys aren't ever.
Alright, Toys, Cat. We are streaming this, right? Help! Help us!
This is great, man. Love it.
Let's see how far we can go. Oh, you can do it like this, too.
Thanks, man.
Right here.
In this episode, we hightail it all the way from Michigan down to Texas with some roadblocks in front of us. So strap in as we check out some flea markets, some vintage toy shops, and guys, welcome to the Attic Invaders.
All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement. I know.
Lost the mic live on the seat.
So we're on the way back home, but we're stuck on the interstate, which is very familiar. If you remember back in, what was that? Going to Indiana to the toy bit with the Sweet Spy guys? Stuck on the intersection, but check out the helicopter. A guy stole an ambulance in Chicago and they chased him down and we are literally right behind him.
Huh? What are you thinking?
This is crazy. This is crazy.
Can I shoot a suggestion?
Sure.
We have a parking lot sale with all the toys we got?
We should. That's a great idea.
We got all these toys.
I mean, why not?
We're going to be sitting here for a little bit.
What do you think about this?
I mean, it's tiring.
helped you.
I can't find the cheese that came with my White Castle fries. So I guess okay. We all have our own problems.
That's good.
Do you want to stay on the ambulance and find out why?
This is crazy.
One, two, there's one over there.
Nothing to see here. Moving along.
Get him, Murphy!
Moving along. Nothing to see here.
So we got Robocop.
We can add 209 here, man.
And there's 209!
Oh, we're going.
Hey!
You
ready?
What are your prime directives?
We got Greg.
We got it.
We got Greg.
Thank you. Thank you.
On this episode of Radical Fabulous, we get pulled over. At this point, we made it home. We were in that van for 17 hours. So the guys were like, what's next? Let's hit up a flea market and some toy shops. What's going on, guys? Attic invaders in the house. We are at Bird's Flea Market in Cleburne, Texas. Guys, flea market right there.
Bird's
Flea Market. But you guys pumped?
Love flea market.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I saw some Batmans.
Yeah. What'd you see?
I see people buying all the stuff we should be getting, so let's hurry this up.
Yeah, let's do it. Cue the intro. What'd you find there?
Transformer type?
Transformer?
I'm not sure.
Drecky, what is that?
Maybe just like a
stuff. They said two for a dollar.
Nuclear.
Yeah, I think that's Robbie the Robot, right? I think. Robbie.
Robbie.
Yeah, Robbie. Hey.
Planet of the Apes. Really sick. $20
Welcome. You got a McFarlane Freddy. How much you got on him? $10 $10 Would you do five?
Oh, okay.
Five? Oh, you paid five. Gotcha. I understand that one. I understand that one, brother.
Three or two for five.
Oh, that's some good ones, dude.
I could probably get a bigger deal on them.
Yeah.
Just grab all.
Yeah, grab that.
Man. Yeah, I was looking at him. I want to get the Earthworm Jim.
Yeah. What, we got Earthworm Jim down there, too?
Yeah, that one.
Oh, okay.
He's got a gun.
So sure.
This one, Walkabout, is also good.
Yeah.
This is X-Men, but I'm not sure if that's
a
word in the house. Here's a Secret Wars Dr. Doom. No. Is that,
oh, yeah. Put him in the bottle. Yeah, that's good. Yeah.
What else we got over here?
No cool looking
though.
These are Eternia minis.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that.
Kind of cool. Okay, let's get it. It's a
dinner. You want this?
I need that. That's a pickup.
That's a technical
file. That's a technical file. All right, let's see what we can see here.
How many do we have? We got one, two, three, four, five. Mick Medaleo, six, seven.
Oh, and I just got his gun.
Remember? Eight, niner, tenner.
Ten.
10 times 2, about $20.
We got 10.
I can't go any lower than two for either $3 each or 2 for $5.
Okay.
So how does that work then?
So this is 10.
Five times five, 25.
25?
That's 25, right? Because you got...
Yeah.
Five.
Yeah.
You wouldn't be able to do 20 on it?
No. I the bottom, and I'm not merely making, maybe I'm making 50 cents on it.
Oh, yeah, so yeah.
I won't make any money at all.
Okay, we do that.
We're not going to fight about this. We're going to divide them up like gentlemen.
Gentlemen?
I saw him first.
Eddie saw it first. Let's go rub it in Greco's face, huh? Yeah. Yeah?
While you were looking at the games. You're still looking at games.
Dude. Where's he at?
Yeah.
It's right
there.
Greco. What's up? You missed out, buddy.
Did I?
Yeah.
Got all the Transformers. 2 for 10. 2 for 5. Two for five.
You seriously missed out, dude.
Yeah. Got to hold back. So.
Check it out.
Wit weapon.
Those are Transformers. Still.
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 Is, right?
Yeah.
Can you guess how much we paid for the whole bag?
Huh?
Can you guess how much we paid for the whole bag?
$3.
$25.
Ah.
Yeah. Still good.
It's good.
It's good.
Good, right?
I mean, it's nothing crazy. Oh, he just didn't have his head. Never mind.
Wait, that's a Toy Biz
here? Toy Biz blob. Well, never mind.
What else is there, man?
Turtle. Where?
Listen to
him. Oh, yeah. Hi. Hey.
Hey guys.
Alright, we got some wrestlers over here.
Yoko.
Yoko.
I know nothing about wrestling.
How much you got in these?
Five each. You got the YouTube?
Yeah.
Sometimes.
We try. Are you a YouTuber?
Franco, can you get in the shot?
How far back do I gotta stand?
Yeah, that's good.
Right there?
Hey, we're shooting a movie here.
Hey. All right, we got a box of VGA games. Some tacos. Get the best? How much you got on the games?
Different prices. You buy all of them, I give you good deal.
Get the box. Kind of. Toidles. Anything in there, Greggy? Is that a GoBot?
This is a Transformer.
Oh, okay.
Sea spray, so it's not damaged.
Yeah, a little bit.
It's a newer one, then.
You know what that is?
Bones are good. Bones are good. What are they, 2 for $5?
2 for $5.
$3
each.
Okay.
What a driving poop. Pile driver.
There's a nice piece of Rangers.
Hey, at least we're finding stuff.
Yeah.
It could be potentially be like
a disaster.
A Ranger in here. Decent Ranger. Yeah. Little ninja dude.
Little ninja.
The muscle man.
A box of VHS. As Boston Mike would say, any horror.
It's a John Wayne collection.
John Wayne collection.
Yes,
sure are a lot of flippers around.
We buy this. This could be us.
That could be us.
Yeah.
Can I be the guy in the middle?
Everybody wants to be the guy in the middle.
Hey. Got some Nintendo.
Surf thing.
Yeah. And all this. Is that a
Mexican
shredder?
I don't think it's a shredder. I think it's a luchador.
It's a luchador. Yeah.
First off.
All right.
How's my lighting?
It's perfect. What'd you grab?
I grabbed some vintage My Little Ponies, guys.
Yeah.
It's a Pegasus.
It's a Pegasus.
That's cool.
I got yellow horse, pink horse. And the best of the bunch, green horse.
Nice. What'd you get on?
Gotta be a lucky one.
What'd you get on this?
And then also.
And wait, there's more.
A little mini Cabbage Patch.
Oh, that's cool.
1984, I think.
The big reveal, 50 cents a piece.
That's a steal, man. All right, guys, so we're done with the flea market. I feel like we did pretty good, actually.
I'm happy.
Yeah. I got some wrestlers. Eddie got some.
Found the toy he needed.
Grecky got some ponies and
My Little Pony.
Cause friendship is magic.
It's magic. And also he got like a game or something.
Yeah, I got a game I actually want to play.
That's good.
I can tell you what it is because it's none of your damn business.
That's right. We found some really good deals at the flea market.
So next, we are going to check out one of my favorite spots, and that is Empire Toys in Keller, Texas.
Hey! We are at Empire Toys. We tried to come here yesterday, but they were closed. I should have looked that up. We took Boston Mike's word for it, and of course, they were closed. So thanks, Mass. I think you guys are really going to enjoy the store. Lots of vintage, boxed, loose, complete, lots of turtles. They got some turds. What are you guys really looking for?
Good conversation.
They got great conversation. And Eddie's sneaking off.
I don't sneak off.
No, not at all. He didn't do that at the flea market either, so.
Exo Squad, Darkwing Duck, anything and everything.
Okay.
That I'm looking for.
So, I think I've been meaning to ask you, are you trying to just get the Playmates figures kind of knocked out?
Up to 98, yeah.
Yeah? What is, as far as, like, do you want all the Darkwing Ducks, all the Tailspins, or just, like, certain characters?
Oh, you mean Darkwing Duck?
Yeah.
Just everything. Like, it's one line, one way. So, I'm looking for that.
Okay.
Turtle-wise, up to 98, so Next Mutations is where it stops for me. I'll still take those, so.
Sweet.
I already have one.
He has a ton.
Yeah. And Earthworm Jim, Skeleton Warriors, Toxic Crusaders, all that good Playmate stuff.
Yeah.
Found one Exo Squad so far. Just looking for the rest now.
Let's go see if we can go find them.
What are your thoughts so far?
I really like this shop, man.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, I just keep seeing stuff I've noticed before.
Mm-hmm.
Great representation.
Oh, yeah.
Turtles, Ghostbusters. Really checked out the Master Universe stuff. Yeah, but they have some really good stuff.
Yeah.
Damn. Loads of Exo Squad. So definitely walk and hell with one of those. I also got a Storage Shell Raph on card.
Let's
here.
Go check it out.
Here. Got Mikey, got Leo, we have probably the best thing ever created by Playmates.
Yeah.
Over here.
What do you like so much about that one?
It still has the, I don't know, it's just one of my favorites. I think I got it when we were on holiday somewhere,
mm-hmm.
and I played a lot with this toy.
Nice. Love it. I love the head sculpts on those.
Yeah, they got the best head sculpts, man. These are the best. Back in the day, these were like $3.94 at Walmart.
And now
we got one over here for $150. I mean, like if it was €150,
yeah,
I'd have gone for it. But now I'm actually thinking about it. Let's see what we can do.
What
we can work out.
Let's see.
Possibly. Maybe.
Greco. It's a curse of an open. What are you thinking?
I like it. Oh, yeah. These box Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Box fever nowadays.
Yeah, there's plenty of boxes, that's for sure.
Yeah, cardboard fever. So,
is there anything in the boxes? That's a good question.
That's the gamble you take, right? Yeah. You pay first and then you figure it out.
Yeah, no returns.
Is that the one you guys got from Sean?
No.
Is it complete?
No.
The parts are not hard to get. The hardest thing in there
is
the ghost.
He's speechless.
Can I open it up?
He's speechless.
No. Can I open it up? Because I sold him one a while back.
No, I don't.
You got the tabs. That's important, right? Sorry, Ed. You got that gun?
Yeah, he just grabbed it.
You got that? Is a ghost in here? Yeah. What was it missing? You got the chair, you got the wheel.
It was more about things were broken.
Oh.
Like,
take it, my grip, my shirt.
I'm trying to sell this timesheet for my friend Greco here. Choose the best you could do for an out of towner.
Look at this, fellas.
Hey.
Thundercats. You just got this?
Yeah.
Look at that.
It looked like it was buried in dirt.
I was about to say it's not that bad.
He's missing a lot of stuff.
Yeah. It's that compartment. It's not too bad. Not too bad.
Man. Yeah. I've never seen one. Ever.
Which one? Which one do you like?
I really like this one. That
mm-hmm.
one. Maybe.
Just because of the colors or just
yeah,
because?
Yeah, just based on okay. the colors, honestly. It's like really expensive for some reason.
Yeah, I don't know why. I have no idea.
Because that's one we have in the truck.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Sure. I mean, it's the shell. It's there, but. Yeah.
These are
I think I'll try getting two of these.
Mm hmm. Let's just see what happens.
See where it takes me.
Okay. Okay.
Which adventures we might venture into.
You never know.
Oh,
and all these.
They got a Ewoks cartoon
right there.
Yeah. Cool. Trying to see how I did it in the draft.
Right. they got the coins. Coins with them too. Here's your loose turds over here.
I should wait. Like, we got
to see if there's any that I need.
Yeah, mine
was
better.
I do have this Mikey. Wow. That's a good one. Got those. Got those.
My next trip over here with my jellies.
You're absolutely right. Hey, did you guys never get... Did anybody have this guy?
I think I got him. I think I got this.
Are you sure?
Hey, he's getting some lickies in. Some lickies.
Get the Boston
scene. He probably... Yeah, he has it. He has it. It's a Monster Force.
That's
not.
What
are you thinking?
It's a possibility.
How much? What's the asking price?
$30. Not
that's
terrible.
Not bad. It's not terrible.
I'm thinking I throw it in Ed's pile and get a better deal.
Yeah, I think so.
You want to pile up?
We can do that.
We're in Stimpy. That's some Double Dragon. Hey. Vortex.
I always wonder about Metal Gear figures too.
Yeah.
I've never gotten any, but. Ninjara.
Ninjara.
Deep Six V2, Rock and Roll V2, Steel. No, not Steel. I can't remember his name. And I always say his name wrong. I'm not even going to say it.
You're going to mess it up. You're going to mess it up. Don't even say it.
But I get all these cameras on me, just like, you know, when I get home with the paparazzi's all over me.
Yeah, because why? Like you're on IMDb?
I am on IMDb.
It's his wife. DB. Where you been all day?
Actually, my daughter did say that. After the movie, she's like, Mom, are we going to have paparazzi's on our lawn from now on? I lost it. I couldn't stop laughing. I'm
like, yes! Does make you feel extra famous?
Yeah, because she watches that 10 times a day. She's my number one fan.
Oh.
No.
Well, someone's got to like you, buddy.
That's awesome. That's true. That's true. We had some great finds at Empire Toys. Make sure you're following Ed's Retro Geek Out and also Greco Fabulous to see what they picked up at Empire Toys. Now, we are going to Retro Madness because we have a little meet and greet.
Yeah, I'm selling on this piece right here. This is the She-Ra Princess of Power crystal playset. Let me sell you on this piece right
let
here.
Let me show you.
This could be right our timeshare. It's too big to drag home.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, we just got to buy it together.
Well, we're just timesharing.
We're just timesharing this piece. It looks like it's almost complete. It's got some stuff in there. You got you know, spots for your She-Ras.
Now, is it made of actual crystal?
It is made of actual crystal. That's why we're asking $2,500 a piece on this timeshare opportunity.
So we're going to buy it for $160, but we're going to turn around and sell it for $2,500. That's what we're talking, right?
Yeah. Remember, you can't buy nostalgia.
But you can own it.
You can.
Also
Eduardo.
Hey, yo.
Also have the worst carded turtle figure in Oklahoma.
That's for actually you. Okay.
Okay, there you go.
I didn't know this. This is awesome.
Dude, thank you.
Yeah.
I like that. White Ranger Collector Series.
Voltron.
Voltron. It's like Christmas.
I got a pew-pew.
Mike, when he gets here, if he's done.
Okay, he'll be here. Awesome. Yeah, he'll be here. Cool. Thank you, Jeffy.
Sounds like Princess Leia.
No problem.
Greco, tell me about this piece right here.
This was a special delivery for yours truly.
Truly,
I am a great on-camera presence. It's the Teddy Ruxpin Picture Show. Projector. Why can't I talk?
Can you go?
I think it's his, like, drink I had.
Ruxpin, I would like
now
to
now Teddy
you.
Can tell you a story in a whole new way.
We started carrying the coal to the airship.
He can do it in a bed. After he can do it overhead. He can do it with a friend. Airship. He can even make it bend. He can do it down the hall on a ball or on a shirt. It won't hurt.
I love Teddy Ruxpin. This is like a little projector thing. I don't know if it comes in cassette form, maybe. Like,
that's cool. That's
yeah,
cool.
I haven't seen this in action, so I'm kind of curious to see if it'll.
Yeah, I didn't. I honestly didn't know that was a thing, so that's cool. These kids are enjoying it, so it must be cool.
They love it. Right? I mean, if they do, I'm sure a 37-year-old man will as well.
Yeah, I mean, why not? Guys, that will do it for this video. Make sure you subscribe and hit that like button. Let me know what was your favorite thing that we picked up. Let us know down below. And also, check out this next episode.
And a 12-back A card. This card in particular is the debut card.
I hope we can stay here for a while because we can have a lot to look at, honestly.
We got a bunch of boxes of vintage stuff. When we get to it, we'll give you a call and you can come take a look.
Oh, the doors.
And the doors
are opening for us.
The doors just opened for us.
And the big gray ones.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hell yeah. Oh, I think there's some down in there.
Here we go. Mighty Max.
Look at that.
Hey.
Oh,
hey.
Look, don't hit our workers. Avoid $10,000.
When?
When what?
When are you going to drop another Spidey Sense? October?
How far away is October?
All right, guys. So this is day 4.5 recording our film. And guess who is in the house? We got...
Yeah, but he wants to
vlog style. It's Retro Geek Out. We got Rube.
You're actually going to have...
And we got Greco.
By me, please. Turn on Chris.
For a while, because we can have a lot to look at.
See
something?
It.
Say something.
You say something.
Here
we go. Mighty Max.
Look at that.
This is exciting. This is what we live for, right?
We only have 2 episodes left in this series, and we had 2 Dallas Vintage Toys, and also a crazy, crazy find at a local thrift store. Let's get it. All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement. I know we gotta get it.
What's going on, guys? We are at Dallas Vintage Toys. Look who's with me. We got Ed from Ed's Retro Geek Out. We got Greco. Fabulous. And we are the Attic Invaders, baby. Fresh off our trip from Chicago. I'm sure, at this point you'll see most of it. So I'm gonna take these guys inside. Ed's never been here.
No, I wanna go. I saw videos and stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm really excited.
He's super excited.
I've been excited since 8:00 this morning.
Yeah. It's like, let's go to DVT. Bye. Greco's been here.
Been there, done that.
The
back too.
But this is one of the, this is like the flagship store of vintage toys here in the area, probably in Texas. So you're gonna see a lot of cool stuff. Hopefully you buy something and let's get it. about the Omnibot 2000?
It's a robot.
Greco, better answer?
It's a servant.
A robot, servant? Yeah. Okay. Do you know it? I mean, do you have one of these? Did you have one of these?
I definitely had something growing up. I don't know if it was that one. I had one that like at least carried like a tray for you, and you could like control its weight.
Emilio.
He's from Italy. Hey.
I think like this started mid-80s. And went up into the mid-90s, honestly. It was like 10 years of like, you know, Christmas time. Sometimes you would get some really cool big presents. And what are things could you do as a toy company, but, you know, sell like a giant robot for your kid to play with.
I think it was spurred by the, you know, Rocky IV, right?
Yeah.
When Polly got the robot.
Short Circuit, like, you know?
Short Circuit, yeah.
That time period. Sweet.
It looks kind of creepy.
He does.
No.
You don't think so?
He has a lot of soul behind those eyes.
I mean, it's serious robotics, but it's just...
But just for fun.
Just for fun.
Yeah. Not too serious. No.
What's your thoughts so far?
I hope we can stay here for a while because we can have a lot to look at. Yeah. Honestly, that's a cool knockoff.
This thing right here.
Yeah. Pretty sweet. Get that box here, place that too. That's cool. Box crane.
That's insane.
Nutty.
And some turtles down there.
I remember seeing this figure. So this is the Big Lebowski, the dude. I freaking love this movie. This is series 2. And this is $70. That is super cool. I would probably consider that. I don't know. But always kind of been on my list low-key to pick up. This is the first time I've seen it in a while, so very cool. Alright, so we have some of the O3 line right here. This is Fighting Gear Donnie right there for $30. There's a Casey. What else do we got back here? We got a Fighting Gear Leo. And we got that dude. Very cool. On card. And then I think this is some of the re-releases. Baby Turtles. And then we got some of the reissue Ghostbusters.
That's nice.
That's real nice.
This is Clash of the Titans.
Mm-hmm. Very good shot.
That's good.
Oh.
And Earl.
Oh, Frank and Earl.
They live at Dallas Vintage Toys, and they're pretty cool.
I know where Frank came from.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So that's.
I have been seeing them in the pictures.
Frank and Earl, yeah, I try to pollute Instagram with them.
Love it.
So, you know, that's fun.
So this is a double telescoping Luke on a 12-back A card. This card in particular is the debut card. This one received a AFA 80. The card got an 80, the bubble got an 80, and the figure got an 80.
Wow.
I believe this one went in one of the books that came with the figure. So this is kind of like a mock-up. So they would have it in black and white. Then they'd have the watercolor version of it, and then kind of all the little details. These are all the artist notes for that go into the production of it.
Hey.
See, I don't know what to do.
What do you think?
I really liked it. I think like the layout, and especially that they put so much effort into keeping
their displays up to date and
yeah.
have new stuff rotating around. Mm-hmm. What I didn't know and what I was glad about that you told me mm-hmm. is that, well, you know, if you're looking for something, just ask them.
Yeah,
have like a ton of inventory online.
Tons.
That's what we did, and that's how I got those Mario Commandos.
That's nice.
So I'm pretty happy.
Yay.
Happy, happy Ed.
Happy
Ed. Happy Ed.
Yay. Yes, sir. Two months ago, I went to my local thrift store called Thrifted It in Justin, Texas, and I got to know the owner pretty well. Drew is a awesome guy. Drew was telling me that we have a lot of vintage toys in the storage area, so whenever you have a chance, you want to come back over, you can totally dig through it. So that's what we're going to do. So we're at Thrifted It in Justin, Texas.
Thrifted It.
There's some part of Animorphs. We got some, looks like some Jim Lee action right there. Bonkers.
Ah, real monsters. Some Primal Age.
Just a bunch of random figures here. Like this guy, T-Bob. Got some wrestlers up here. There's John Cena. What is that? Do you know?
Is that a thing?
A reptile.
Take that out.
A reptile?
An interesting center.
Yeah.
Is that round up? Is it attached to an even number or something?
I don't think so. Maybe it does. Space Jam.
This
is 95. 95? 95 Soho.
Ooh. Is that like a
dip? Could be. Worth a look. What did you find there, Dad?
A Inspector Majigger. Gadget. Inspector Gadget.
Magellan.
Magellan Gadget.
Who makes it? Alright guys, bear with the wind. But we are at Thrifted It in Justin, Texas. I brought the boys along because this is a place I bought all those Mighty Max and Polly Pockets a while back. Here's the link right there. Check it out. But the owner at that time said, hey, we got a bunch of boxes of vintage stuff. When we get to it, we'll give you a call and you can come take a look.
Oh, the doors.
And the doors
are opening for us.
The doors just opened for us. So we're going to go in the back and see what we can dig out. Are you excited?
I'm so excited.
And?
I'm pretty excited here.
Yeah.
What's the word for it?
What's the word?
Super excited.
Yeah. Let's go invade some stuff, guys.
Here we go. It's fun to see, too.
Yeah.
That's fun to see. The CDs, mm-hmm. Because we got a music section coming.
Okay.
DVDs, CD players, the old portable CD players, tapes, you know, all that stuff. Records, vinyl, all that stuff.
That's awesome, right. Man. Cool. We're going to go through all of this stuff over here. These boxes... I'm not going to pan over there, but apparently there's some good stuff back there too. But that's back there. So we'll start with this stuff, see what we can knock out.
This is a real treasure hunt, guys.
Yeah. Y'all don't mind if I take a video of y'all.
No, God, no. So I guess I'm going to start with these boxes and we can go one by one.
Yeah.
Sound like
yeah,
a plan?
I'm going to get right okay.
on
it.
Okay.
Yeah, let's be fair about this.
Be fair about it.
Say something.
Say something.
You say something.
Something.
All right, we're doing
all right.
I see a box.
I put it down
yeah,
here.
Sure.
And let the
sure.
let the hunting commence.
We'll get down.
Beyblades, right?
Yeah,
there's
Beyblades.
Something similar to that.
Something like that.
Got a whole heavy pack right there. Oh, hey, or, here you go.
Hey,
there you go. Little sidekick.
Oh, yeah, that's a good piece.
Action.
That's a good piece.
So you want me to
ski
this up?
Oh, Fantastic Four.
Oh, wow, you don't really see Fantastic Four stuff.
Whoa. No.
Or at least I haven't ever seen it.
And here's the cart that goes with it.
That's pretty neat.
That's cool.
Oh, what is that?
Ooh, what is that? What is that? Hey.
Is that what
you
like?
Hero Academia.
Yeah.
Stuff just right. Well, that's the X-Men thing.
Oh, the headquarters,
no,
right?
No way.
Beast Wars.
No way.
What?
There you
no
go.
Way.
Oh,
no
Beetleborgs?
Beetleborgs.
Wow.
3D.
Is that GH?
This is good stuff.
Is that... No. Congo? That's Congo.
Yeah.
West wow. Vader.
Yeah, I guess a Beast Wars in here for sure. Nice. There's Megatron?
That's Megatron. That's yeah. Megatron. That's the metalized.
Which one is this? Beast Wars has kind of been a thing this week, right?
Yeah.
Like, we've been talking about it a little bit.
It's cool to find some.
Yeah.
Sure.
All right.
Okay. Get an idea of what's in there.
Is that mask?
No.
That's cool, though.
Oh, the mask.
The mask.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the vehicle.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Hey.
Hey. You don't really see that.
Hey. It's a lot. Yeah, these are a lot of...
That's like, fucking random bits.
That's, Look,
look
who it is.
Nope.
Nope.
Any little guys you see in here? Bears seen bears. The micro machines?
Micro machines.
Yeah?
Wow.
Alright.
You mean on the side?
Is it it's actually missing, gargoyles?
It's missing one thing, though.
Eddie, what's do you know? This is,
I'm not sure.
Burger King.
Oh, that's a handle. Where do you actually open it up from?
Micro machine
so
case.
That's the hinges there. All right, here we go. Oh, little city. Yeah, you got some things in here.
You got some friends? Oh, yeah.
Helicopter. We got a stretch limo.
There you go. That's cool.
Yeah.
I never seen
that's
that
that's like
one.
The president. Yeah, this is like the...
Presidential micro machine.
Yes. Ooh, pretty neat.
Box. You
want to open it up? Oh, we got a recorder.
Ooh, hey.
Alright, hold on. Okay.
Oh,
Ronin.
Ronin.
I've seen a few of these on this trip.
Happy Meal Boy.
That's
ooh,
cool.
That's
hey.
Three
hey. Hey.
That's cool.
Kind of exchangeable.
Yeah.
Making me hungry.
Ronin.
Let's do it.
Look at those.
Look at those.
Z-Bots.
What turtle is it? Oh.
Pizza throwing.
Yeah.
It's a pizza throwing.
Yeah.
Leo.
Very good shape.
It's a shooter, I think. Where are these dinosaurs?
Yeah, like a
Frankenstein.
Here
we go. Mighty Max.
Look at that. Bag full of lots of Mighty Max. That
bag. Polly Pockets. Mighty Max guys.
Is this Toy Biz?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, and this is a tiny snailian.
Okay.
It's part of a snailian's desk. Oh, and this is, what does this go to again? The head.
That's
a ring.
Horror
heads or?
Goosebumps.
Goosebumps.
The goosebump ring.
Oh my god, goosebumps.
Goosebumps.
And our Z-Bot. Oh man, this is good stuff. Man.
Some wrestlers.
This is Tarzan?
Oh. That might be, yeah, that's Tarzan.
Hey.
Oh, Adrian.
There's a bot of some kind in there. On bot. Top.
What is this? Power Rangers.
Power Rangers?
Okay. Power Rangers. Yeah.
Get some more Toy Biz in there, too.
Alright.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
wow. Crazy.
Hello, my name's Oriella. How are you doing today?
How are you doing today? I'm a dog.
I'm a dog and I'm sleeping on the bed.
Yes, let's open this up. Ooh. Oh, there we go.
Hey.
That's some good stuff.
Hey.
There we go. Pirates. There's more.
Hey.
Fantastic Four.
Toy Biz.
Not gonna lie.
Kinda cool.
That's cool.
It's kinda cool.
I mean, it's missing a bunch, but...
How often do you see this stuff?
First time.
Same here. It's weird, right? For Toy Biz?
Oh, it's got the top.
Shuttle.
I don't know how that works.
A Hero Academia.
Alright guys, so our plan, Rico, come over here, is...
On the inside?
We're running out of time today. Because it's towards the end of the day. We're about to close up. I'm going to ask them if we can come in the morning and we do like a part two of this thing.
I think it's definitely worth coming back.
Yeah.
There's more good boxes than there are boxes we're not interested in.
Yeah.
So taking that average in account. It's best we spend our time here and over at some garage sales.
And we didn't really like dig through everything. So
this is a sure thing.
Okay.
This is a sure thing. Attic invader is always a sure thing.
I'm stuck.
Greco gets stuck on the next attic invaders.
The boys are digging deep.
Greco, how are you feeling about this, bud?
I found a portal to Belgium. This is exciting. This is what we live for, right?
Yeah.
It's over here. This one, just gonna dig around, guys. I mean, I'm here now.
Aren't those some droids right there?
Are those the droids you're looking for?
I don't know. It's just a combo VCR DVD player.
Bike helmet over there. Okay. You said you saw a VHS?
Over here, yeah. See some Wallace and Gromit. Okay. Oh, what's this?
Not sealed. Whoa. Hey.
All that should be like all crammed up underneath there. That's been kind of our dump.
Have you seen any?
All in there. We haven't even messed with that kind of stuff.
Have you seen any like Nintendo games or anything like that?
I remember the one I played with. Golly, what was that? What was before Super Nintendo?
NES.
NES.
Yeah. Or the, Atari.
The cartridges. The.
Yeah, the big gray ones.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
Hell yeah. I think there's some down in there. But that's where you're going to find all that goodness.
Okay.
DVDs, VHS, it's all just kind of...
Well, there is room here to potentially move some stuff around.
Okay.
Let's do it.
All right, so we're digging through. We got our box right here. As you can see, we got some turtles. We got some masks. We got McFarlane, Snailians, Zebots. Beast Wars.
Notre Dame, it says.
Oh, yeah, that's for the Hunchback that's in there. I'm digging through these right now. Ed.
You need all the little duties?
I need all the little duders.
And you want the Power Ranger dudes?
Do you want the Power Rangers? The minis?
They don't go to the Zords, though.
All right, we're still digging along. We got this translucent Mighty Max. We got some little bits in this bag, which are pretty cool. We got some Polly Pocket Mighty Max Goosebumps and these little troll things that I like. All right, so we are kind of, I think I want those. We're looking, this is everything that we pulled out. As you can see, Mighty Max,
Zebots,
Snailians, Goosebumps, Beast Wars, Greco and his Beyblades. But we're assessing the situation, trying to get a number in our head to make our offer. So we will keep you guys updated and see what happens from here. As you can see, we had some really good luck. That was a ton of fun digging through a whole storage unit looking for vintage toys and video games. So this is what I took away from it. Guys, make sure you check out Thrifted It. Their details will be in the link below. Check them out. Drew's an awesome dude. So go check him out. Support those guys. So it always sucks. It's time for Greco to go. So Ed and I drive him to the airport. It was really, really sad because at this point, we've been together for 7 days straight. Watching Greco walk into the airport was pretty freaking sad. It was the first one of us to leave. And we only have one more day left. So stay tuned to the next video.
I found this in Europe, in Greece.
I was stressing for like 2 seconds.
Too, because I didn't bring a charger, but I knew there's one in there I haven't used yet.
So I'm here with Captain Flanagan, reporting for duty.
Captain Flanagan, here, at your service.
At your service. What's going on? Hey, go behind Flanagan.
probably found the only vintage piece
in the hole. This is the last one from the Attic Invaders series. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Myself, Ed, Boston Mike, and Captain Flanagan, we go to Texas Frightmare Weekend, and we actually find some vintage toys in there, which is pretty crazy for a horror convention. I stay tuned because in the last premiere, I did a little vote asking if you guys wanted to see all the episodes of the Attic Invaders all in one video, and it was a unanimous decision. Everybody voted yes. So I'm adding some never before seen footage to this video because myself and Ed went to Raul Paleon's house and saw his collection and it was insane. So that's gonna be an extra 20 minutes of footage that's never been seen. And if you have not yet, check out the Attic Invaders merch. The link is down below. All the proceeds from the merch will go to our next adventure, which will be coming up this October. So stay tuned. We are getting back together. We are definitely going to Retropalooza in Arlington, Texas, one of our favorite cons. It may be something else, maybe something crazy out of this world. You never know. So stay tuned.
All right, Greco, what do you think? Another town?
Another basement.
What's going on, guys? We are at Texas Frightmare Weekend here at the airport. We're at the airport. Ed's first time. Mike, you ever been here?
No, never been
Me
here.
Either. No. I've never been here either. So that makes three of us. Special guest appearance today by none other than Captain Flanagan. That's right.
Captain Flanagan. They call me Captain Flanagan. They call me Captain Flanagan. They call me Captain Flanagan.
If you remember this video, I grew up with this guy and he's in town and he was like, hey, I got some extra tickets. Why don't y'all come out? So that's what we're doing. And hopefully we can see some cool horror stuff. Look at that. What's going on?
I'm here with Captain Flanagan. Reporting for duty.
Captain Flanagan here. At your service.
At your service, Matthew. Where are we going?
This booth? The big one?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see what it's all about. Oh, really? Today?
Look at all them NECAs. All them NECAs. We got all of this.
And all those t-shirts.
Which one?
The mask? Okay.
We want to come play. Look
at those aliens. Godzilla's. That is cool. It's Resident Evil. $95.
It's a mess. It's a mess. You got Chucky's walking around. Can't even move. You got Father Comic-Con over there.
All right, so you picked up one of each? Good pickups, man.
Super 7 reactions. And they got those Lost Boys, Son of Frankenstein, Mummy. Punchback. Oh, yeah. Ed, what do you think, dude?
There's a lot of people here.
A lot of people.
It was only 43. It's not bad.
Yeah. What do you think?
It's good. It wasn't bad. It was fun.
Yeah. It was fun?
Yeah, so far. We're done, right?
Yeah, we totally bonded.
Yeah. Totally bonded.
We totally did. It was super fun.
Captain Flanagan?
Hey. We got recognized.
You did?
Yeah.
Nice.
Got in the line.
Oh, yeah. He's like, you Ed Retrovica? Yes, I am. I'm a big fan.
That's awesome.
And
hell yeah.
Like, dude, get away, man.
Wait, you should have been his security.
Huh?
You should have been his security.
I was, man. I was like,
it was like, I don't want to take up any of your time, but I'm like, we're stuck in line.
Line. Do you want to hear?
See, well, you don't realize if you're a celebrity.
That's not true.
Okay, once you're on IMDb, you once realize. You realize.
You, you recognize him, right?
I mean, of course, you gotta watch this. Yeah.
Hey, he loved the movie.
No, the best part of the movie is when my head blows up, yeah. And Craig's like, oh shit.
Motherfuck.
Turtles.
So should we get into a line?
Oh, that was my favorite.
Yeah, we can walk in. We can walk in over here.
No, okay, the first...
That's what makes it so good.
The first day was very stressful. It was really... None of us knew what to do.
Yeah.
The second day, we were a lot more relaxed. They weren't really barking orders at us and yelling at us, you know.
Yeah.
And then this new movie we're doing right now, I'm so relaxed.
Yeah.
Prequel, I'm just so relaxed. It's like... You messed up your line, just go with it.
Yeah, yeah.
Just
yeah.
Be who you are. Boston Mike, Narc, Eric.
That's cool, man. That's cool. Mm. Do that shit, man. Do that shit.
Oh, it's fun.
It'll be better, man. It'll be better.
It's a lot of fun. It really was.
It's my favorite too, man.
The prequel's awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey.
I'll just give you a little hint or a little preview. Yeah. I pissed my pants.
All right. We got
the what?
Collector. Midday.
Peace.
What's going on, man?
Not much, just melting. And you?
Yeah, so usually we see each other at toy shows, but this is a horror convention.
Yep.
It's my first time. It's pretty cool, man. So what did you come to see? Like, what was your main objective for today or this weekend?
Well, just the main objective is Freddy Krueger, okay. Robert Englund.
Father knows best.
Yeah.
The line is King Mangus. They already cut the line. They start at 5 and 5:30. They cut the line.
Done.
So no more autograph, no more nothing. So we're going to try again on Sunday, probably very early in the morning.
In the basket?
Are you going to get it, dude?
If he can reach his finger out, phone home, I'll get it.
Okay.
It's a carry-on.
Carry-on. It is a carry-on.
No, can't reach.
It didn't work, but that is a pretty sweet piece. I don't know, man. I don't know. Maybe you need to phone home and find out.
If you can, Captain Flanagan says, if you can do it, you can do it.
You can do it, man. You can do it.
But I don't know if I can carry that home.
E.T., he can phone it home. I think it's all NECA. This is Trick or Treat Studios, which is a really good. They make really good figures.
I mean, they're really good.
Damn, Trick or Treat, I love that.
That's a really good Michael Myers. Predator.
20, you said?
Got this reactor below Godzilla.
Oh, wow.
I like Predator. That's what caught my eye.
89?
What's that?
89 for Predator.
Okay. Let's take a look.
Oh, it's sealed.
Oh.
Sealed.
Okay.
That's your brother's hard. Any. Most books aren't bad enough. Just say all of them.
I don't know.
So Ed is looking at this vintage Star Wars Dupac. Is that vintage though? Is it vintage?
It says 97, yeah, but...
79, dude.
Confused my numbers. Problem.
I mean, $20. I mean, not terrible. Maybe 15?
Take 15. Cash. Yeah.
All right. Buying to do that. Yeah, that's a good get, man.
Look at my channel.
Watch me.
Watch my channel. Watch my channel.
Watch me.
It's very good, you know?
Watch me. So, you picked up...
I probably found the only vintage piece.
In the whole convention.
Awesome.
You got a lot of Star Wars this trip, dude.
Yeah, it's a Star Wars kind of trip.
That's right.
It's, yeah.
You got old Dewey Cox.
I'm bringing it over to Europe tomorrow.
You know what? I can see you walking around with that Paul Bear mask.
I think so.
You should do it. You should do it.
Should I ask how much or should I just buy it without asking?
No, ask how much.
You just throw money and take it.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
How much you guys got in the Paul, the one in the bottom corner? The
Paul Bear, dude.
I couldn't think of the bear. The Undertaker's man.
Paul Bear.
Paul Bear. You said 40?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
40?
Yeah.
40 cash?
Oh, that would be... Well, I can text the guy. Because that's not...
Asking 40 cash, I mean, cash is king, right?
Oh,
I think so.
Is that Laserdisc? Monster Squad?
How much you got on it?
Ooh.
I want that.
120? Yeah.
Okay.
Which?
What'd you find? No. Oh, there we go.
There's some satanas.
Yeah.
$40, dude.
Freezing Moon is an awesome track.
Do you have a record player?
I do.
Nice.
I don't use it, but I have
one. Okay, okay.
It's a ritual.
It's not a ritual.
Mike.
Another band that I saw a very small place.
He's like, I went to high school with them.
I did it. My buddy did it, right?
I went to high school with them.
Do you know anybody famous?
Yes, Ed Retro Geeko.
Flanny, what you got?
Hey
Flanny.
Hey, look at this.
Hey, you're making the deal too quick. What you got in there, Flanny? Flanny, what'd you get? A bunch of soundtracks?
Ooh, yes.
Oh, yeah?
Let me tell you.
Okay. Tell me about it.
Okay.
Let Flanagan pay for it first.
Let Captain Flanagan play for it first. What's going on? Hey, go behind Flanagan.
You got it?
Yeah. I'm just trying it out.
No, $40? Hell yeah. What's that mask collection? What do you think? I got the Darth Maul. I got the tons of them already. Tell me that.
Yeah, walk.
It's Paul Bearer. I'm going to get a suit. I'm fat like him. I'm going to wear it.
Oh, you got to get a suit.
I got to get a suit. Urn. See if Eric can get me an urn.
Oh, that's great.
Undertaker. Woo. I'm dead. Hey.
Woo! Smoke it. Do it.
I can't find the hole.
Stupid.
It still has a tag on it.
How did you make this?
It's hot, Aaron.
Yeah, that's a good find. That's awesome. How much are they asking?
Yeah, how much is it?
Is that still underneath the other foot?
Other foot.
Fitting?
Yeah.
Me. I don't know.
What's the Snarf.
That's interesting.
You got a Phantom Flyer?
Yeah, I get a
is
Phantom
it sealed?
No. I mean, it's open.
Yeah. Womp. So you don't see this too often?
Do you see him too often?
No, I don't. Do you?
Want to make a move on him? Tell him something? I mean, Mike.
Yeah, so it's right on.
The last one for some reason. This was yesterday.
Yeah, they did that so they could sell it here.
Yeah. Good call. Good call. Scary. So these are graded up here?
Yeah.
Graded?
This one's 1,000. This one's 750.
Okay.
This one's 1,000.
Look, first print or variant or the different country? Should say.
What's that say, Ed? You speak nine languages.
This is cool. I've been looking for this one. $50. This one, $45. No, you're not. You're not wrong. You're not wrong.
And then see, like, Back to the Future. So they might have some.
Look, Attack of the $5. It's not terrible.
These are some weird looking Nintendo games, I tell you.
Some weird looking Nintendo games. It's a good one. Sleepaway Camp. Right there. $200. Check that out.
Oh, great movie.
And then you got all the streams over there. Yeah. All of them.
Do I have a friend that wants
it? I do. You do have a friend. Yes. That's a good one, too. You do have a friend that wants that.
Should I hand it over to my friend?
No kidding. I found out Freddy was the
one. $7.
Spaceball. I got it.
Should I hand it over to my friend?
You should. You really should.
Go ahead. You wanted it.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to pick this up.
You're going to get it?
Yeah, I'm going to get it, dude.
Do I need to film you?
Yeah.
Do I need to film you getting to it?
Please film me getting to it. Okay. But I'm going to offer 20.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, come on.
Hey.
No, we call that the Greco style.
The pickups from Texas Frightmare Weekend. All I got was that Toxic Avengers Part 2 on VHS, which I needed, and I ended up getting it for $20. It is a really, really good deal in my opinion, so I'm super happy to add that to my collection. But also stay tuned to Ed's Retro Geek Out, because he is starting to put out videos from the trip as well. Check out Greco Fabulous as well, because he should be putting out some videos here soon, maybe? I hope all of you guys enjoyed the footage from the trip. It was a crazy trip. Unexpected things happened, which in my opinion was the best part, because you never know what's gonna happen on the road for 7 days, but it was a lot of fun. So guys, until next time, peace.
Another town,
another basement. I know we gotta get it. I know we gotta get it. Know we gotta get it somehow. I know we gotta get it. I know we gotta get it. Know we gotta get it somehow.
Hey, what's up?
Hello.
they produce this whole line, but this is the only one that I could find available, the Murciélago Dormilón, which is this bat. And you know, it looks kind of a cheap bootleg toy in a baggie, but
it's made by a toy company.
The thing is, it's licensed.
Warner Bros. licensed.
It's licensed. Mm-hmm. So it's not a, you know, it's not a bootleg toy. And then all of these Lionels as well. Here's the, you know, the orange version. This is the Brazilian. And then we have the Playful. This is the Playful, this is the Argentinian. I found this in Europe, in Greece. So it's a different painting, and then a couple of bootlegs. And I just got the Stilt Runner, but it doesn't have the red dots, and oh, it's always broken. Yeah. Always broken. So
they have superpowers.
It's a cartoon, right?
Yeah,
it's amazing. Like France?
Yes.
Oh, so much.
Yeah, they're huge stuff. In France.
Yeah, yeah.
This guy, he does a tiger shot.
Okay.
So whenever they shoot,
in mm-hmm. game.
Yeah. Well, actually, the PlayStation 4 game just came out a couple of years ago. He was huge. He was the goalkeeper, so you could not get a ball through him. He was like a superstar. And this is the main guy. In Spanish, he was Oliver. In Japanese, he was Captain Tsubasa. And, you know, he did the eagle shot.
Okay, gotcha.
Yes, and I don't remember Tom what he did. But, you know, I mean, they had all kinds of special moves.
That's cool,
special
though.
Special powers.
I like that.
Yeah, they were interesting. They were really, really big.
I was stressing for like 2 seconds.
Because I didn't bring the charger, but I knew there's one in there I haven't used yet.
Mm-hmm.